Hello everyone, welcome. In today's video, we will be doing an updated comparison of the game Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, running on the Yuzu and Ryujinx emulators. We will be testing the game's stability in both the main mode and the World of Light mode. Additionally, we will be conducting a performance test with 4 and 8 players on the screen, and we will also be evaluating the unlocked frame rate to determine which emulator provides better performance under similar circumstances. So, get ready to find out which emulator is the best for playing Super Smash Bros. Ultimate, and before we start, we'd like to ask for your help. If you're enjoying this type of content, please leave a like to help us spread the word. Also, if you enjoy news and emulator comparisons, don't forget to subscribe to our channel to receive new videos every week. This way, you won't miss any of our exclusive content about the world of gaming.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel. Thank you for your support.
Let's start with the World of Light mode, which for a long time didn't work properly on Yuzu. When using this emulator, you may encounter some crash issues when starting a new game. If this happens, you can try downloading a save file from the internet or creating a save on Ryujinx and transferring it to Yuzu. During gameplay in this mode, both emulators may experience problems if you play for many consecutive hours. In Ryujinx, random crashes may occur during loading, although this is not very common. On the other hand, Yuzu has a memory-related issue. After starting many matches, the emulator accumulates a large amount of unnecessary data in memory, which ends up affecting performance and loading times. If this happens, the solution is simple: just close and reopen the emulator so that the memory is cleared and performance returns to normal. I also noticed that in the latest updates, Yuzu consumes an excessive amount of memory compared to Ryujinx, making it practically impossible to have decent performance with only 16 GB of RAM. In summary, if you want to play World of Light, our recommendation is to use Ryujinx as Yuzu still has some issues that can affect your gaming experience. However, it's important to remember that each emulator has its own advantages and disadvantages, and the final choice depends on what you value most in your gaming experience. Now, let's move on to the next test and see how the emulators perform in Smash mode. To start our tests in Smash mode, we decided to evaluate the performance of each emulator by putting 8 CPUs on the screen. The goal of this test is not to evaluate the loading speed or shader compilation, so we started capturing each gameplay after 30 seconds of gameplay, which is roughly the time most shaders have already been compiled. Once again, Ryujinx demonstrated a significant advantage. The game ran at 60 frames per second almost all the time, consuming only half of the VRAM compared to Yuzu and with a large memory RAM economy. In addition, the frame time of Ryujinx is much more stable. Yuzu lagged behind in all aspects, except for CPU usage, which was lower. It is important to remember that results may vary depending on your hardware specifications and emulator settings. Therefore, it is always good to conduct your own tests to see which emulator best suits your system. For our third test, we decided to simulate a more common situation, with only 4 characters on the screen. In this scenario, both emulators performed very similarly for most of the time, resulting in a technical tie. However, Yuzu continued to consume more RAM than Ryujinx. Despite this, the frame time of Ryujinx was considerably more unstable. It is important to remember that this instability can be corrected by using VSync in your GPU software. At the time of recording this video, we chose to test with Ryujinx's default VSync, as we will also be running tests with unlocked FPS. Finally, let's move on to our test with unlocked FPS and 4 characters on screen simultaneously. I like to say that the test with unlocked FPS is the one where we can really notice which emulator delivers the highest final performance, and here, Yuzu performed better. At times, it even delivered up to 100% more performance than Ryujinx. The gameplay on Ryujinx seems to have some stutters, while on Yuzu it appears to be smoother. The only negative point of Yuzu remains its excessive RAM consumption. And thus concludes our comparison between the Yuzu and Ryujinx emulators running the game Smash Bros. Ultimate. We hope it was helpful for you, who is looking for the best gaming experience on emulators. It's important to remember that these tests were performed on specific hardware, and there may be performance variations on different systems. Please leave your opinion in the comments about which emulator you prefer and why. Don't forget to leave a like and subscribe to the channel for more videos like this. Thanks for watching and see you in the next video.